King Rinkitink was filled with horror when he heard this, but the prince answered as boldly as before, saying, "We are not frightened by Bluster, believe me, nor are we so weak as you imagine. We have magic powers so great and terrible that no host of warriors can possibly withstand us, and therefore I call upon you to surrender your city and your island to us before we crush you with our mighty powers." The boy spoke very gravely and earnestly, but his words only aroused another shout of laughter. So while the men of Regos were laughing, Inga drove the boat well up onto the sandy beach and leaped out. He also helped Rinkitink out, and when the goat had unaided sprung to the sands, the king got upon Bilbil's back, trembling a little internally, but striving to look as brave as possible. There was a bunch of coarse hair between the goat's ears, and this Inga clutched firmly in his left hand. The boy knew the pink pearl would protect not only himself, but all whom he touched from any harm. And as Rinkitink was astride the goat and Inga had his hand upon the animal, the three could not be injured by anything the warriors could do. But Captain Buzzub did not know this, and the little group of three seemed so weak and ridiculous that he believed their capture would be easy. So he turned to his men, and with a wave of his hand said, "Seize the intruders!" Instantly, two or three of the warriors stepped forward to obey, but to their amazement, they could not reach any of the three. Their hands were arrested as if by an invisible wall of iron. Without paying any attention to these attempts at capture, Inga advanced slowly, and the goat kept pace with him. And when Rinkitink saw that he was safe from harm, he gave one of his big, merry laughs, and it startled the warriors and made them nervous. Captain Buzzub's eyes grew big with surprise as the three steadily advanced and forced his men backward. Nor was he free from terror himself at the magic that protected these strange visitors.